Well, I froze up completely last night. It only went down to minus 9 Celsius, but I done froze up completely. And I'm going to tell you why that happened and why I'm not going to worry about it, because it's going to happen to you. If you live in these types of conditions, your RV is going to freeze up too. Let's get to it.
Welcome.
You are watching Line Screw 1. Wow, look how cold it is. I couldn't even get into my battery bank right now because we got icicles. I'm wondering, where is all these icicles coming from? It's because the roof is so warm from all the heat I'm running. It's melting and causing icicles. I'm going to have to get that open in case I have an electrical fire and I need to get into the battery bank. I will have to melt this huge chunk of ice. I got icicles everywhere outside here with the RV, but hey, it's winter in Canada. What do you expect? Ah, winter in Canada in an RV, living full-time in the RV. What are you going to do except either prepare or accept? That's all you can do. Okay, I got my gloves on, so I don't freeze my fingers while I'm doing this video outside. The reason I'm doing it outside is because we've got more light, especially with all the snow everywhere, the lights bouncing off the ground. So anyway, I froze up completely solid. I'm going to tell you the story of how it happened and what I did and how it shouldn't happen to you. And if it does happen to you, don't worry about it. Here's the deal. I got up at about 3 in the morning. I went to bed early at around 9 because it was Christmas Day and, you know, whatever. You don't have to, you know, stay up late on Christmas Day unless you're partying, I guess. So I went to bed early, got up at 3 in the morning. The water was still running good and I decided to have something to eat. I was feeling a bit peckish because I had a big meal very early like many of us do in Christmas. So I was feeling peckish and had something to eat and had a shower. I like to have a shower at least once or twice a day. Call me crazy. I'm not like the other nomads that like to shower, you know, once every few days. So I had a shower, went back to bed, got up at 8:30 in the morning, turned on the water to brush my teeth, and got into water. So I'm thinking, what the hell happened? You know, when I went to bed, it was minus 7. In the morning, it was minus 9. Well, so I went to the pedestal, checked to see if the water is flowing out of the ground. Yeah, that was good. The heat tape on the pedestal was flowing. I checked to see if my heated water line was frozen. No, it wasn't. It was flowing just good. So obviously the water was frozen inside the RV. The mistake I made was this. I focused a lot more on the front end and the back end and ignored the middle end. The middle end is the RV. So I've got everything heat taped and I'm, my sewer's not gonna freeze up too bad. And I'm flushing with windshield wiper fluid. And the water coming in is not gonna freeze either. But I made the mistake of thinking that I've been to minus 15 before in this RV and I didn't crack the cupboard doors. My bad. I didn't take off any of the access panels or the cupboards, so obviously there was one point where it actually froze somewhere in my RV, because the water line sometimes hugged the bottom of the floor or the actual wall somewhere. So you're only as good as your weakest point, apparently. So somewhere it froze. So what I did was I opened up all those panels, started forcing hot air through the entire system and all the bowels under the cupboards. And it got so hot, my bathroom hit 51 degrees Celsius. That's pretty hot. It's very hot, actually. So I went gung-ho on the heat. That's why you need to have electricity in the winter, either from a generator or from, you know, shore power, or else you're going to freeze up, because I don't know how I'd get this unthawed if I didn't have that. So tip of the day, make sure the cupboard doors are open and maybe even put the furnace on at a certain temperature if it gets below a certain threshold. It didn't get below probably 72 degrees all night. But here's the kicker. Tonight we're going down to between minus 14 and minus 21. Hard to predict. I think they like to over predict in case it does go to minus 21 Celsius. And if it does, it's going to be a bitch. So a lot of people in these RV parks going to have problems. I predict at least probably 30% of them. Because here's the deal. A lot of RVs have different design plans where the water lines go. Some have exposed valves, some have heated valves, some have heated tanks, some don't. Everybody's different depending on what kind of RV you're using. So, my advice to you is don't take a chance. Just open the cupboards. Let the heat flow in. Maybe even direct the heat towards them. That's what I didn't do, but I will do tonight. And another thing, if it does happen to you, don't worry about it. I wasn't worried even when it first happened to me because most modern RVs have PEX lines, which are plastic water lines. Oh boy, the sound sure travels. There's a train like miles away, you can actually hear it right now. Anyway, these PEX lines, they expand, so they're good to about minus 20. So worst case scenario, even if you could not get them unthawed, you just wait till the temperature changes or drive your RV to someplace where it's warmer and hopefully the lines haven't burst and you're going to be okay. That's all you have to do. Just wait it out. Flush your toilet with windshield wiper antifreeze like I'm doing so that the tanks don't freeze. Or just wait. It's all you can do. You either fight it or accept it. I fought it and I won. But tonight's going to be a bit of a challenge because it's going to be so cold. So what I'm going to probably do is take some cat naps, go to bed early, check the water lines every couple hours, make sure everything is flowing properly so I don't have to deal with this again, because it's going to be probably the coldest night of the year tonight. And what can you do? I'm in Canada. Look at the snow. Look at the snow. Now, luckily, the snow is actually quite powdery, so I don't have to even worry about the weight of the snow. It's another thing you have to worry about with an RV. If the snow gets too heavy on the roof and there's too much of it, it could actually cause you problems structurally. So I don't have to worry about it unless it starts raining. I don't think there's going to be any precipitation until at least Wednesday, so not really a big deal for me. I'm not going to worry about it. But if you are worried about it, put your questions and comments down below in the comment section. And maybe I'll give a tip for you. Maybe somebody else will have a tip for you. Because we all got to get through this, you know. What can you do? It's winter in the Northern Hemisphere. Actually got a call last night from New Zealand. It's the beginning of summer for them. And old William, Kiwi Van Man, he's still building those RVs. And everybody down in New Zealand is enjoying camping right now while we're all freezing our butts off. So a little shout out to Kiwi Van Man. If you haven't found him on YouTube, go and check him out. I've hung out with him down in New Zealand a couple years ago. Good guy. Check out his channel. Very interesting. And if you want to maybe rent or buy an RV from him in New Zealand, he's making them right now. So go check him out. In the meantime, folks, stay safe. Keep your water lines unfrozen, and I'll talk to you soon. Over and out. I got you.